Former National Economic and Development Authority Secretary Carl Chua is tapped as an independent director of the DNL Industries. In a disclosure to the stock exchange, the manufacturing firm said that with Chua's election, majority of the board will continue to be held by independent directors. Chua replaces Filemon Berba, who served on the board from 2012 until his passing last April. DNL President and CEO Alvin Lau welcomes Chua to the board, saying he brings a fresh perspective with his distinguished experience as an economist. DNL also announced a record dividend of 30 centavos per share, consisting of a regular cash dividend of 24 centavos per share, plus a special cash dividend of 0.6 centavos per share to shareholders. And the Marcos administration eyeing to sell over 100 idle government assets worth 2.5 billion pesos this year. Finance Chief Benjamin Diokno says the sale aims to shore up revenues for the government's priority projects. This move is supported by architect Felino Palafox Jr., who chairs the 49th Philippine Business Conference and Expo.
We've been involved in the planning of the largest airport in the world in Bulacan, and Clark Freeport and the airport. I saw so much potential, even maybe addressing vacant land, underutilized land, the wrong land uses at the wrong time, at the wrong place at this point in time. There might have been the right land use in the right place at the right time in 1946, like many underutilized government properties. I think they should be put to productive use. Anecdotal research tells me Metro Manila has 8,000 hectares of idle land and much more underutilized land.
In the first 6 months of the Marcos administration, the Privatization Council approved the final sale of 800 million pesos from the approved 1.9 billion pesos worth of assets for disposition. The total sales collected from the previous administration between years 2019 to 2021 amounted to 660 million pesos. Israel's foreign minister is in the Philippines for a visit. Earlier, he joined a business forum where he pushed for direct flights from Israel to Manila. Katrina Domingo is on the line for more on this story. Hi, Kat. Over to you.
Hi, Stanley. Israeli Foreign Minister Eli Cohen has marked his historic visit to the Philippines with several events in the capital city today and a vow to collaborate with the Philippine government to further strengthen the two nations' bilateral trade and relations. Before meeting President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. in Malacanang this afternoon, Cohen told Filipino and Israeli business groups that Tel Aviv will be working with Manila to open direct flights to the Philippines. He says that both governments will work together to open direct flights starting in 2024. And he thinks that this will be great news for the tourism industry and the business community. He says his goal today is quite simple. It's to build a bridge for the business community to increase the trade volume between the two countries. Now, in 2022, Stanley, the Philippine Airlines said it would launch direct flights to Tel Aviv, but the plan was stalled after the flag carrier cited concerns over geopolitical uncertainties in the Middle East. Now, the head of economic affairs in Israel's Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Yael Revia Zadok, says that these direct flights may be more doable next year, especially after Israel signed the Abraham Accord. It's a deal where several Middle Eastern countries vow to recognize the importance of peace in the Middle East and to settle challenges through cooperation and dialogue. She says the two governments are ready to explore ways to support this push for direct flights because these would be key instruments in order to increase business and tourism for the benefit of both countries. She also says that the Deputy Director General of Israel's Ministry of Tourism is also in the Philippines and that he will be meeting with tourist agencies and officials in order to explore exactly what should be the values of the vehicles for the Philippines and Israel to increase tourism and support the aviation's direct flights to both countries. Now, meanwhile, Stanley, aside from opening direct flights between the Philippines and Israel, Cohen also said that Israel is hoping to increase its bilateral trade with the Philippines to over $1 billion by next year. How that will happen, we will have to see as the days pan out. Stanley.
All right. We look forward to details on that. Katrina Domingo, thank you so much for the update.